Good afternoon, dear colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, dear organizers. First of all, let me thank you warmly for your kind invitation to this workshop, I think, on a very actual topic. As I was introduced, I'm working now for the executive agency for small and medium-sized enterprises, but I have close links to the Commission, not only because I worked there for 10 years, but also because my agency collaborates closely with different services of the Commission, and I will say a little bit more about that later on. I will speak today about the European support for buildings energy performance assessment and certification. And I will divide my presentation basically in three parts. I will start first with the, let's say, legislative framework, which comes renewed in the Clean Energy for All Europeans package. Then I will move to presenting what our agency is doing in the field, give examples of projects, and at the end, we will also move to the opportunities that there are still available in the Horizon 2020, and as it has already been introduced by the chair. So Clean Energy for All Europeans package. This is the recent package that comes as a part of the European Energy Union, about which I think you have heard a lot in the past. It's about, as it says on the slide, creating jobs and growth, bringing down greenhouse gas emissions, and securing energy supply. Of course, the driving force behind this package was to create opportunities. Under jobs and growth, the energy sector alone in Europe employs close to 2.2 million people who are working in over 90,000 enterprises across Europe. The package has the potential to deliver up to 900,000 additional jobs and up to 100 billion euros in GDP gains by 2030. Speaking about global clean energy transition, we would like to translate climate ambitions into concrete climate actions. And EU, with its new technologies, to secure a leading role in global clean energy transition. There is also the aspect of the energy security. Fossil fuel import bill savings, up to 290 billion for the period 2021 to 2030, compared to business as usual scenario, internal energy market should also support diversification of import sources. Moving also to consumers, share of energy spending in low-income households is around 9%. Energy efficiency measures should bring significant energy savings for all consumers. They should also become prosumers. That means that they should be able to choose when and how to satisfy their energy needs. Of course, there are also many challenges. Challenges in energy efficiency is certainly a need to increase the rate and depth of buildings renovation from current 1% annual rate to a much higher rate. Renewables. We would like Europe to be a continuing leader in race towards energy innovation. Electricity markets should be made fit to renewables, and renewables should be made fit for the markets. Finally, we should provide a fair deal for consumers. They should have necessary tools to make them benefit from the energy transition, should be able to access the right information, to recognize energy community's role, and to have access to smart technologies. Energy efficiency update, what is progress to date? Within this clean energy package, the revised Energy Performance of Buildings Directive was published on 19th of June and entered into force on 9th of July 2018. The second is a revised Energy Efficiency Directive that was published 21st December 2018 and entered into force a few days later. Commission has also tabled the proposal for the revised tire labeling regulation, which was adopted in May last year. And what is under preparation is also revised new eco-design and energy labeling regulations in different areas, which you can see on the slide. What is the focus of the EPBD review? There are many good reasons. you can see them on the slide. For example, 75% of the housing stock is energy inefficient. They are missing the benefits of increased renovation. Renovation rates are too low, and we need to accelerate and finance building renovation investments. And we should also tap the potential of smart building technologies. Also, in Energy Performance of Building Directive, what should be the main outcomes of its revision? Firstly, stronger long-term renovation strategies for member states that would aim at decarbonization by 2050, which would also have a solid financial component. We should introduce smart readiness indicator for buildings, target support to e-mobility infrastructure deployment, enhance transparency of national building energy performance calculation methodologies, which I think is also one of the relevant topics of the workshop today. Last but not least, we should also reinforce building automation, provide additional requirements on room temperature level controls, for example, and build automation and controls and enhanced consideration of typical operating conditions. Moving to the core topic, one of core topics of the workshop, on energy performance certificate. We have heard what they are and what they should provide, which I don't want to repeat. We, as the Commission, as the legislator, look very much also at the impacts of energy performance certificates. Therefore, the Commission has procured a study on the impact of these certificates, which was based on an analysis of residential markets in Europe. And there are already some results available that show that higher energy savings resulted in substantially higher sale or rental prices on average. Place of the energy performance certificate in this new clean energy legislative package. They have not undergone any substantial changes during the review of the legislation. And that was a conscious decision. The Commission decided not to touch them in the legislation, but to work more on the implementation. And that was an intentional to focus on implementational aspects rather than the legislative ones. The Commission and the Member States are working to improve how the information is provided in the certificates. The information itself, the recommendations, calculation methodologies, quality mechanisms, and so on. Now moving to the second part, something about our agency, Executive Agency for Small and Medium-Sized Enterprises, and its role in the activities on energy efficiency, and how do we work together with the European Commission. EASME is one of the six executive agencies that the European Commission has created since last, let's say, 15 years. I'm sure that you have heard and maybe worked together with some of the other ones, which are Research Executive Agency, EA, or European Research Council Executive Agency, ERCA, NEA. These are just a few others. The rationale behind was to separate policymaking, which the Commission is doing, from the implementation of the programs and project management. And in EASME, you can see on this slide what in the current financing period, 2014-2020, we are dealing with in our agency. We implement parts of Horizon 2020, and that in particular, the energy efficiency part of the secure, clean, and efficient energy societal challenge 3 of Horizon 2020, then part of climate action, environment, resource efficiency, and raw materials. Also the SME instrument, I'm sure you have heard a lot about this, or maybe you have even participated in proposals or in the projects. It was one of the novelties of Horizon 2020 to bringing research and innovation results closer to the market. Then also we implement the program that is called COSME, and COSME is an acronym for Competitiveness for SMEs program. LIFE program, European Maritime and Fisheries Fund, EMFF, Intelligent Energy Europe, and Eco Innovation. The agency has about 500 staff organized in three different departments. So much about the scale and scope of our work. here you can see, let's say, schematically presented the programs that we are managing also with the budget and the share of the budget. So the overall budget that the agency is managing under the current seven-year multi-annual financial framework is around 10.4 billion euros. You can see that the biggest part goes to different parts of Horizon 2020. That's about 7 billion. Next comes LIFE with 2.3 billion, COSME 0.7, and the smallest program is EMFF, 0.3 billion euros. Now, a bit more in detail, what is the, let's say, the scale and the budgets of different parts of Horizon that we are managing? First comes the SME instrument. I mentioned already that this is a novelty of Horizon 2020, to which intentionally a very high budget was allocated, 3 billion euros. It's out of the scope of this presentation to present this SME instrument, but as I mentioned already, it's an instrument that was put in place to support innovative SMEs. You can even apply if you are a single SME, and it goes in different phases. So there is a phase one, phase two, and finally phase three of this action, which has been proven so far quite successful and will continue also in the future under the so-called European Innovation Council. Second is the climate action, environment, resource efficiency, and raw materials. That is a program which is called Societal Challenge 5 in the Horizon 2020 with the overall budget through 7 years, 2.7 billion. And third comes energy efficiency of the Societal Challenge 3. Societal Challenge 3 has a broader scope, but our agency implements only the energy efficiency part, and there are other agencies that implement the rest. Two other actions, innovation in SMEs with 0.3 billion and fast track to innovation with 0.2 billion. Now, giving you some, let's say, flavor of the types of projects that we are funding, we have selected deliberately projects from different, let's say, areas, just to give you a bit of an example. And let me start with this project Energy Positive. That is the project that was implemented in France, in Île-de-France. It's one of the central regions in France. And it is about all-inclusive designed, implement, operate package with guaranteed energy savings, which dealt with the renovation of eight condominiums. You can see one of them on the photo on the right side of the slide. So for eight of them, works have been launched with the budget of around 38 million euros to impact over 2,000 homes, and the project has already created almost 1,000 jobs per year. There is much more work in the pipeline, 28 more condominiums, and what is also important to note here that this is one of the first successful projects that benefited from the so-called European, the FC, European Funds for Strategic Investment Loans. So the EU grant of 1.5 million euros has created financial leverage effect of this factor of over 25, which is quite an impressive figure. Next come a portfolio of projects in high energy performing buildings area. There on the right hand side you can see a catalog. We will not speak about, going into detail presenting each of them, but say a few words about their commonalities. As you know, the European building sector needs innovative solutions to enhance the building stock energy efficiency and to help to meet the energy and climate policy targets on a broader scale. Horizon 2020 supports a number of projects addressing design and construction processes, but also new technologies. Results developed by these projects address key challenges at each stage of the value chain for new nearly zero energy buildings, deep renovation of existing buildings, and energy smart buildings. Then the further example is the project Transition Zero. It was a three-year project, 2016-2018. And it started with the Dutch Energy Sprong company that has brokered a deal for 11,000 dwellings to be renovated to the standard of the passive house. The works on the house takes less and less time, and in some cases is down to one day in best situations. There is a guarantee on performance so that there will be no energy bills for the renovated houses for next 30 to 50 years. So far the project has created 30,000 new contracts in Netherlands, but also 5,000 in UK and in France. Aimed at some technologies so far to be mentioned, mostly excellent insulation of prefabricated modules combined with air heat pumps fueled by photovoltaic panels, both integrated in building structure, like in facade, roof, or staircases. There are many more examples the successful projects in energy efficiency areas. Anyone interested is warmly welcome to visit the website to see the further information on the projects and also get, maybe if needed, also some contact details of the project coordinators. And now, and to my last, almost last part, I mentioned already, and also in the introduction, it was mentioned that one of the purposes of this workshop is also some networking in preparation for applying for last calls of the Horizon 2020. And my intention is to mention a topic or some topics that relate to energy performance assessment in certification. You can see here Horizon 2020 topic. EE05 2018, 2019, 2020. It is the topic that came recurring, but had a little bit different orientation in different years. So you see here, for example, what we want to achieve with this kind of actions. There are a number of specific challenges. As you can see, that assessment process and energy performance certificates have to become more reliable, user-friendly, cost-effective, and compliant with European legislation. They also need to reflect the smart dimension of buildings and to facilitate the convergence of quality and reliability of the certificates across the Union. Should assess the buildings in a holistic way and should ensure a technology-neutral approach, make use of international and European standards, such as ISO and CEN. Further challenges about the assessment, they should be based on indicators such as calculated annual final energy used, share of renewable energy used, past final energy consumption and expenditures, comfort levels, levels of smartness, and so on. The assessment should increasingly also take into account actual measured data from sensors or smart meters, and should also demonstrate how schemes could be strengthened, modernized, and linked to national certification schemes. So out of this topic, in 2018, that was the topic of the type of projects that we called coordination and support actions, focusing on market uptake. The three proposals were selected for funding. And here you can see what are the common characteristics of these three successful proposals. I will not read all of this. You can see yourself. Basically, what we also have assured with funding three proposals is that there would be a complementarity between them and ideally also cooperation between the running proposals, running projects. And now coming to the topic to which you will still be able to apply. And in this area, the topic in 2019 is not the coordination in support action, but it's a real innovation action, a real innovation project. And here you can see the scope of the action. We would like to have innovative approaches for assessing building energy performance and reliable assessment of building intrinsic performances. The work should be output-based assessments using available building energy-related data. The projects should deal also with improvement of reliability, cost-effectiveness, and compliance with standards, and to allow EU-wide deployment. Should, of course, involve relevant stakeholders, including certification bodies. and consider using energy performance certificates in buildings, passports, and renovation roadmaps. Here you can see some further details about this action. Approaches should rely on the combination of existing and proven technology components, starting at technology readiness levels 6 to 7. They should have well-structured methodologies and protocols that can lead to define new certification schemes. We will support the successful projects with the funding rate from the EU side 70%. Indicative budget of action is between 2 and 2.5 million euros. Registration will open in a month and a half from now, on the 12th of March, with a deadline of 3rd of September. And the more information you can find on the web link here. There was also, I think a week ago, the info day in Brussels about the next call in energy, in the societal challenge 3, including energy efficiency. Maybe some of you have been there, but if you have not been there, you can still see the, let's say, the video of the info day on the web. And also what is very important, because it's also one of the evaluation criteria, is the expected impact, what we want to achieve by funding this type of projects. Certainly the project should contribute to the improved user friendliness of the certificates in terms of clarity, accuracy of the information provided, should enhance user awareness of building energy efficiency, primary energy savings should be triggered, investment in sustainable energy also should be triggered, and should reduce the emission, should contribute to reduction of the emission of carbon dioxide and other air pollutants. And all this, let's say, reduction should be quantified in quantitative terms. Now, although today we are not on the info day, but let me also maybe give you some, let's say, tips or do's or don'ts about how to prepare a successful proposal. First of all, I think you all know, and this is something that Commission and also agencies have been sometimes criticized, that to our calls the success rates are relatively low, unfortunately. We have, which means that we have a lot of applications and not that many succeed. What is also frustrating for us sometimes, that despite Horizon 2020 having a substantial budget, there are many times, unfortunately, proposals that are evaluated above threshold, but we cannot fund them due to the lack of money. Coming back to a few, let's say, practical tips, in preparing proposal, of course, you have to explain very well your innovative approaches. Crucial is also the composition of the consortium, so you have to have relevant stakeholders on board, which in this particular case are certainly certification bodies and energy agencies. Cleverly choose your demo cases and explain them in detail. Calculate your impacts, which would also need to have credible baselines, and show how your idea allows EU-wide replicability. Last but not least, read the topic carefully. You can believe me that when we were, the Commission colleagues were drafting the topics, it was a lot of work behind. So every sentence there, every word there has been carefully thought. And you should address everything what is in the topic. Do not think that if you will address some aspects vaguely that would pass through evaluation system, because it will not, in particular in such a high competition. Now I came to the end of my presentation. It was there was a lot of information, very many different aspects tackled, but I hope I managed to show you how the new European energy policy translates into the programs that we fund, and how these projects that we fund from the programs fit then also back to have even better policy on the European level. Thanks a lot, and I wish you all the best and the success with the workshop. Thank you.